St. Petersburg, a cradle of Russian history. Since 1703, when Peter the Great founded this city and opened up a window to the west, it has helped shape the course of world events. Today, the Russian team of Angelika Krylova and Oleg Ovsyannikov look to retain their dominance over the world of ice dance and continue to push the boundaries of their sport. As France's Marina Anissina and Gwendal Pezera challenge the top duo in one of the season's most compelling rivalries. In pairs, Yelena Berezhnaya and Anton Sikhorodlidze, the world champions, have taken their place in the celebrated line of great Russian skaters. While one of the season's surprises, Shuhei Shen and Hongbo Zhao of China look to threaten the Russian dominance. And Americans Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman hope to stand on the podium. From St. Petersburg, where the Tsars once ruled a vast empire, today champions will be crowned in a city with a tradition of royalty. The vibrant colors of the Church on Spilled Blood, one of the countless dramatic scenes here in St. Petersburg. Well, the economic woes continue to dictate daily life, but for at least one weekend, the attention turns to figure skating. And many of the world's best have earned their way to the sports and concert complex for the ISU Grand Prix Final. We hope you were with us last night as Alexei Yagudin met all expectations through a homecoming party to win the men's crown. And Tatiana Malinina of Uzbekistan pulled off a stunning upset to win the ladies' title. And hi, everybody. I'm Terry Gannon. After a succession of sanctioned competitions over the course of the season and held all over the world, the Grand Prix Series culminates here in St. Petersburg. Today, the top pairs and ice dancers from those events skate for the titles and the first place prize of $50,000. Now, the pairs are up first, and here's a look at the names that have made it to this final round and the points earned in their two mandatory competitions coming in. The world champions, Yelena Berezhnaya and Anton Sikhorodlidze, at the top of the leaderboard with 24 points and the two wins in this series that they had. We welcome in Olympic champion Peggy Fleming right now. They have dominated all year long, but you can't take anything for granted in this sport. It's not Berezhnaya and Sikhorodlidze, but Shen and Zhao of China who are in the lead after the short.
Well, Terry, while Shen and Zhao are very exciting to watch, I feel they may show some insecurity with this amount of pressure. This is the first time they've ever been ahead of the reigning world champions, and it's only because Berezhnaya and Sikhorodlidze had a very uncharacteristic short program. Elena made major errors and at one point seemed to almost give up. But this couple is so full of life and talent and elegance that one off night shouldn't cost them the championship. And joining me now is the czar of figure skating, Dick Button, whose Russian Rogaine seems to be working wonders.
Я очень рад с вами познакомиться. And I will tell you, in addition to that, I'm very happy to have a full head of hair, even if it is a Russian head of hair.
And yet it does come at a price, because you know there's a
Thank
skunk.
You very much. We don't need the rest of that lot.
There is a skunk somewhere in St. Petersburg freezing right now because of that.
What really interests me here about this competition is how Russian pair skaters and ice dancers have dominated this sport over the last 40 years. I mean, we instinctively think of the names like the Protopopovs and Rodnina Zaitsev in pair skating and Pakhomova Gorshkov, Linichuk and Karpinosov in dance. It's been a very powerful history, and that tradition will show up in the competition that we're going to see here today.
Thank you, Boris. Here's a look at the standings heading into this pair's free skate. Shuhei Shen and Hongbo Zhao of China trying to pull off the upset. Berezhnaya and Sikhorodlidze don't want to lose here at home. The French team, Sarah Abitbol and Stefan Bernadese, in third, just ahead of the Americans, Ina and Zimmerman. And the first pair to take the ice, the lone Americans in this event, Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman. A second and a third place finish in their two Grand Prix Series competitions this year. And they are in fourth place after the short program.
The music, Phantom of the Opera, Andrew Lloyd Webber.
Only their first season together. And they recently captured the silver medal at the U.S. National Championships.
they're opening their program with side-by-side triple toe loops.
Now, these side-by-side triple jumps are essential for pair skaters.
Oh. And he obviously fell. Not a very good start.
Well, you know, it's interesting that that particular side-by-side single moves, which have very little to do with pair skating, are one of the most important elements in pair skating. It's rather misplaced importance, I think.
And this is what they fell on at the Nationals. A little rough on the landing. And now side-by-side double axels. Oh, and he fell again.
You see, it's interesting that technically he is the question mark in this pair. He's very uneven technically, but he's very dramatic. She is less dramatic, but technically far more secure.
But their new coach, Tamara Moscovina, says, we don't need to be in a hurry. So they are going to take their time to get used to each other's timing and technique and overall look.
Well, I think they'd better get in a little more of a hurry than they are right now.
Maybe.
Oh, that's sad. That's unfortunate.
Kyoko, of course, the two-time U.S. champion with her former partner, Jason Dungeon. And it has been interesting to see how they've been received here in St. Petersburg this week. Peggy, you mentioned Tamara Moscovina, now their coach, one of the legendary Russian coaches.
And they'll be staying here in St. Petersburg, training with her between now and the World Championships in Helsinki.
Side-by-side jump combination of the simplest order of jumps.
I think they were supposed to be starting out with side-by-side double axels and ended up being a single axel.
This a throw, triple salchow. Watch him lift her into the air.
Lift like this needs a little more extension on both of their parts, more pointed toes and more extension in her body. Disappointing performance for them.
Well, I hate to say it, but I think it was uninspired. It didn't follow through. It looked as though they were tentative going through the entire thing. And worse, I think they just don't look as though they've gotten together as a pair yet. They're two totally different styles. The applause is very modest. And I hope they can pull their act together a great deal more before the World Championships.
And this was their opening side-by-side triple toes, where they started off pretty good, good in the air, but he ended up falling. He just didn't hold on to that landing. He wasn't really over his skate enough to hold on to that. It was a disaster opening. And this was the throw triple loop in which she was like anticipating that landing and ended up falling.
Their coach Tamara Moskvina in the red with her husband Igor next to her. She better be working overtime the next 2.5 weeks leading up to Helsinki. The first set of marks, all 5.1s for Ina and Zimmerman.
If you notice, the difficulty comes in the triple jumps. That's where the problem is. And that has really very little to do with pair skating. That's the solidity of the skater as an individual.
A 5.1, the rest 5.2s for presentation. So Kyoko, Ina, and John Zimmerman obviously disappointed with their performance here in St. Petersburg. More of the pairs free skate to come. And here are Maria Petrova and Alexei Tikhonov in fifth place after the short program. A win at Nations Cup, a second place finish at Skate Canada, two competitions in the Grand Prix series. They won the European Championship this year.
And they have wonderful presentation. And they also have only been skating together for 8 months, just like Ina and Zimmerman. With side by side, triple toes, inside three takeoff, very solid, very together.
Those are very steady, well done, not extravagant side by side triple toe jumps. Those are exceedingly important in the marking system. I think they shouldn't be because they're individual moves, not pair skating moves, and that's what this sport is supposed to be. This event is supposed to be all about.
And side by side double axles. Doing three turns into a double toe. Their unison is incredible. Nice and smooth. Triple Salchow lifts her off of that back inside edge. Nice lift, good control.
Did you notice how she opened up before she landed at the peak of the jump? She finished the revolution and then descended. That's the way a jump should be done.
Should point out that their win at the European Championships due at least in part to the fact that Yelena Berezhnaya was forced to pull out because she was ill. So the world champions did not compete there.
A beautiful stretch on that forward inside death spiral.
But it was a rather weak descent into it. She looked as though she was almost about to sit down on a chair. That's a mistake that many pair skaters make. They're very conscious of their style and their position.
Their body lines are so similar. This makes them a very natural pair.
Yet the height difference is extraordinary. She is only 5 foot, he 6.5 inches. Oh, that was a very, very sloppy fallout. Something's happened here.
Look at this beautiful unison on these side-by-side flying camels. Good extension.
Yeah, but something's wrong here. They're just not performing very, very well.
very slow combination spin.
Wonderful ending lift.
They were wonderful.
But, you know, I don't know what happened to them at the end. It seemed as though they slowed down tremendously, as though they weren't grasping the opportunity, but playing it very conservatively. And that was the fact that they fell out of that last carry lift. It was, I think, rather unsettling.
Here at home in St. Petersburg, though, plenty of support, most on their feet in this building. They're trying to make the jump from fifth all the way up to first, Petrova and Tikhonov. When we continue, Chu-Wei Shen and Hongbo Zhao of China, the unlikely leaders after the short program, they skate for the win and the upset next. Welcome back and a look at the Golden Dome of St. Petersburg, St. Isaac's Cathedral. It's been open since 1858. And it is one of the largest in the world. Well, our coverage goes primetime once again with the World Figure Skating Championships. That's Thursday, March 25th, beginning at 9 Eastern and Pacific here on ABC Sports. Michael Weiss, Alexei Yagudin, Elvis Stoichkov will be there as well. And then the ladies take the ice Saturday, March 27th. Our coverage beginning at 8 o'clock Eastern and Pacific. The three-time U.S. champion, Michelle Kwan, again, trying to win the world championship. That's all here from Helsinki, Finland on ABC Sports. Now, it is a long shot, but they went from fifth to first after the short program at the European Championships, and that's what they're trying to do here.
And this is their throw triple Saukow that was done very well. Good height, good control, plenty of time for her to come out and do that nice landing. Good speed.
And in this very interesting move, watch him press her up, and now watch her drape herself over his single arm lift. And now he'll push her up and out. That's a very nice lift, very unusual.
And now the first set of marks for technical merit, 5.4 up to 5.7. 5.4 coming from the Canadian judge, and there are no Canadian skaters in this event.
And look at the interesting mark that the Canadian is giving for the second point.
Even lower, 5.3.
Yes.
And the range all the way up to 5.7. This crowd doesn't like it at all. The pair's title on the line here in the Grand Prix Final in St. Petersburg, and here are the leaders after the short program, the surprise leaders, Chu-Wei Shen and Hongbo Zhao of China. Two second-place finishes in their Grand Prix Series events this year.
And this couple has lots of energy and spark, and they really pay attention to their line. Side-by-side triple toe loops. Very nice. Very calm, very much in control.
Oh, that was a marvelous twist. Triple twist.
Coming up is a throw, triple loop, back outside edge takeoff. Oh, beautiful. Just light, easy. There's a crispness about their moves, very polished off, a lot of energy to every move they make.
Now a forward death spiral. That's a very difficult position to achieve, the forward outside edge. Now this throw triple salchow is one of their more spectacular moves. Notice her landings, how secure they are, how clean the edges are. There's no jerking from back inside to back outside edge.
Remember, they skated at the Olympics last season and came in fifth, by far the best finish for a Chinese team ever. And they've been on a roll. They just won the Four Continents competition last week.
Individual skaters, although he did a single axel there. Jump combination. Beautifully pointed right foot.
Oh, good for them. They should be very proud.
That was a difficult program for them to do, very difficult.
They have been a pair with enormous potential, but you can't call them up-and-comers anymore. Starting to realize that potential now. And you know the Russians are feeling the pressure after that performance. Xue Shen and Hongbao Zhao of China.
And this was the beautiful throw triple loop they did earlier in the program. Nice lift. Good control on the landing. Good extension on that landing position.
And look at how easy he gets her up into this lift. Right there, he presses her up. Now watch him switch to a one-handed position while she goes into an almost back star and then a layout and a push down, push out just before she sets down. That's very nice.
There we go with the first set of marks now. And you expect very high ones. 5.7s and 5.8s for technical merit.
And those are very high marks.
And now for presentation, Dick, 5.5 from the German judge up to a 5.8.
And of course a 5.6 from the French judge, who still has Abbie Bolland Bernadies coming.
Absolutely. But right now, the leaders, Shen and Zhao, as they did after the short program. The world champions are up next. Yelena Berezhnaya and Anton Sikhorodlidze in second place, playing catch-up, but with a home crowd behind them.
This competition is really important for us because all our parents, our friends, everybody who knows us here in St. Petersburg will be here. And we want to skate in good because, you know, it's really exciting for us. It's our city.
They'll take the ice after this message and a word from our ABC station.
Welcome back to the Grand Prix Final. St. Petersburg in the month of March is one of blizzards and freezing frost. But nothing can diminish the glory of the Hermitage, one of the world's great museums. With more than 3 million items in its collection, credit goes to Catherine the Great, who added thousands of important paintings in the mid and late 1700s. The aptly named Winter Palace, part of the Hermitage, shows the glorious excess of the imperial monarchy, all marble and gold and sparing no expense. Although the economy is in chaos, let's face it, the ruble is in rubble. St. Petersburg has some high-priced names and elegant stores. It even has some of the most familiar sights. This is Baskin-Robbins, where the 31 flavors do include Rocky Road, but as yet, no Banana Karenina. Terry?
Yeah, and Leslie, I believe she was winner of the 1925 European title, right? And Tolstoy was a great coach back then. Well, here are the world champions, Yelena Berezhnaya and Anton Tsikhanouskaya. They have been winning everything in sight. They've won every competition since finishing second at the 98 Olympics, but a disastrous short program, and they will try to come back from that.
Well, what sets this couple apart is their speed and their outstanding posture. But they do have to redeem themselves after that short program.
She did a double tree turn coming out of the landing edge. Which means that it wasn't a perfect jump. It's a split, triple twist, and she two-footed the landing.
Off to a shaky start.
There is some room at the top, but there's not a whole lot of room.
You don't need a whole lot. It's a combination, side-by-side combination of jumps. First double axels, and she slid off the edge. And then their timing is completely off on this. This is not a very good performance for them.
You may need a lot if they continue to skate like this.
Triple salchow. Nice. Beautiful extension, beautiful body line, both of them.
Position. As is this. Happened to her, but since she's been in this competition from the very beginning, it's as though she is really not focusing or not in the mainstream.
Right.
Press lift. Oh, look at that dropout. What is happening here? It's almost, this is very sad.
It's very unlike them. She is normally a very competitive skater.
Remember, she's the skater
who ended up with escape from her previous partner in her head, went through operations, was out of it, and has come back so brilliantly that this performance in this competition is a very sad moment for her. Doesn't the audience know that they're way off?
Well, now there's a real tentativeness to every move that they're making. But they're still so elegant to watch. Really unfortunate.
What a sadness there is, I think, to this young couple. Glier's music sort of matched the mood of tonight's performance.
Well, unless the judges were watching something entirely different, the string of victories for the world champions has just come to an end. Sympathetic cheer, one of support from this crowd, but certainly not a victorious cheer.
And this was the disastrous fall she had on the throw, triple loop. She was good in the air, but she was leaning forward and just tilted up on her landing foot and didn't hold on to it.
And look at this lift here. Now watch him press her up into the air. She goes into a stag position and then begins to come down, but doesn't make the turnover. And that, of course, just didn't complete that lift.
Sometimes when you are at home with your family here and all the distractions, it is harder to focus. But I'm not sure you can attribute that performance to being here in St. Petersburg. It has not been good throughout the week for Bereznaya and Sikora that leads it. 5.3 to 5.7, the technical merit.
And 5.9 from Canada for style and position and artistic impression. Wow.
5.6 up to that 5.9 for the presentation mark. So Bereznaya and Sikora Ilidze now in second place.
And a 5.5 from the U.S. judge.
So the final results look nothing like most here thought they would. Shannon Zhao of China with the win over Bereznaya and Sikora Ilidze. The European champs, Petrova and Tikhonov, with a third-place finish, and the Americans, Ina and Zimmerman, finish in fifth place. For the Chinese pair, they have officially arrived. Two straight wins on the international scene. When we come back to St. Petersburg, the finals of the ice dancing competition, and the Russians, Angelika Krylova and Oleg Ovsyannikov, all they've done is win every event since capturing a world title a year ago. But they're being challenged by the French team, Marina Anissina and Gwendal Pezara, who finished second at the European Championships. The free dance is next. Welcome back to St. Petersburg, Russia. Plenty of history and architecture to see, but you go sightseeing at your own risk. We are in the middle of winter and it is very cold, much warmer inside the sports and concert complex. Terry Gannon, Dick Button, Leslie Visser ringside as the ice dance competition. They're set for the Grand Prix final here in St. Petersburg. This is how they qualified. Remember, you had to skate in two events throughout the series. Krylova and Ovsyannikov, the world champions, as well as Anissina and Pezara of France, each winning both competitions in which they entered. They have 24 points coming in, and that has been one of the most compelling rivalries throughout the season. And Dick, you look right now at the world champions, Krylova and Ovsyannikov of Russia.
Well, now, one thing you have to note is for these unusual lifts that they have. They're very intricate moves and difficult, I will tell you. Secondly of all, they had a very risky music selection. It's mostly African drums with no melody, and I'm not sure if that's going to help them tremendously. They do have a great deal of speed, and sometimes she's a little heavy on the emotional projection, but they're a very talented and very expert pair technically.
Right behind them, Marina Anissina and Gwendal Pezara of France.
And they've chosen a much more melodic
piece of music. They also have difficult and intricate moves. Many of the lifts are fun because she lifts him rather than the other way around. Now, they have a great relationship with each other. You really feel as though they're almost in love with each other, the way they dance together. Traditional and emotional theme.
So here are the standings heading into this free dance. Krylova and Avsyannikov trying to win here in their home country. Anasina and Pejara have pushed them all year, though, including at the European Championships, when many in the crowd thought they should have won. Lobacheva, Averbukh of Russia in third place. And here are Margarita Drobiazko and Povilas Vanagas of Lithuania in fifth place.
And the music, Sunrise at Alcatraz by Michael Sanchez. That kind of separation is very rare and not allowed very extensively in ice dancing. Very talented couple. They move with great speed, great energy. They're technically very strong. This is their diagonal step from one corner of the ring to the other. Remember, in ice dancing, there can be a melody and there must be a beat. Many of the ice dancers of the past years took on programs that had enormously beautiful melodies but very little beat. Thank you very much, Christopher Dean and Jane Torval and Christopher Dean.
This is a couple that have worked with Christopher Dean. That was over the course of last season. Now, Povilas Vanagas, 10 years ago, he's 28 years old, but 10 years ago, he was given the choice of joining the Soviet Army or becoming a skater. How long do you think it took him to make up his mind?
Listen to this music. This is all melody, but you can hear an applied tick, 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 which is the beat. They applied that to the music to make it legal. Can you hear it?
Very faint.
Skating to the melody. It's not really an ice dance, and that's very risky in this world of rules and regulations. Do you hear the beat in the background? They're back to a prominent beat. Look at how strong their edging is. How crisp and clean their moves are. These turning lifts. Remember, they must have 5 different lifts, but not more than 7. I find them a very attractive couple. I really enjoy their dancing. I find them technically strong, very fast, powerful, well matched, and I like their musical interpretation.
We always talk about it. It's so hard to move up in ice dancing, but you have to believe they're going to start doing that. A year ago, eighth at the World Championships. This year at Europeans, they finished fifth. Margarita Jovellasco and Povilas Vanagas.
This season, they stood on the podium for the first time at the European Championships. Arina Lebacheva and Ilya Averbuch of Russia skate next from St. Petersburg. Jovellasco, Vanagas, and Yelena Chekhovskaya with a hat that even Dick would not wear.
Well, I must say they were very good. I enjoyed their dancing. Look at this opening of their program, in which they start as two separate ice dancers coming together for one of the required dance spins that they had to do. Very unusual. It must have, by the way, a certain number of revolutions. The rules governing all of this, extremely, extremely precise.
And you will list them at the end of the night for us.
I think if we had another hour of programming, we could do that.
First set of marks, 5.2 to 5.6. Seven times have been the national champions of Lithuania and moving up on the world scene. 5.5 up to 5.8. You can tell they're very happy. Here are the bronze medalists from the European Championships in Prague. They are both from Moscow. Arina Lobacheva and Ilya Averbuch, two second-place finishes in the Grand Prix Series this season, and they are currently in third place.
Also a couple that has wonderful technique and also skates with a great deal of speed. One of the required numbers of lifts that the dancers must do. All of these new requirements have been put in so that the judges can have a very strong list of elements on which to base their mark. This is another one of their lifts.
To take it even further from the subjective to the objective, but things do get complicated, don't they?
Very. See the very deep edges, the very intricate moves. Look at this wraparound lift.
Ilya Averbuch used to skate with Marina Anasina. Now skates, of course, with Gwendal Pesarado still to come and in second place. But he fell in love with Arina Lobacheva. They've been married now for a couple of years.
I think you can tell that in the way they relate to each other on the ice. This is truly two dancers skating as one. Long shoot the duck. Interesting position. Elegant lift, moving into a spin. Those are twizzles right there. By the way, there's a required number of twizzles that most of them must do. This is straight line step. Very complicated. This is a diagonal footwork sequence. You know, that's a very technically difficult dance. They skate with great speed, good energy. And they have really a delightful relationship between each other. They have so far at this point been ranked fourth in the world, fifth at the Olympics. And it's a big question as to how and whether they'll move up.
They know they're ice dancing here in Russia, especially in St. Petersburg. And a nice applause for Arina Lobacheva and Ilya Averbuch. Coming up next, Angelika Krylova and Oleg Ovsyannikov. For them, this is homecoming weekend.
We're very happy to come back in St. Petersburg. We very like skate here. Public like us very much. I think this help and the public take care of us.
They lead after the original dance, and the world champions will take the ice after this message and a word from our ABC stations. Irina Lobacheva and Ilya Averbuch awaiting their marks here in the ice dancing competition. And the first set, 5.5 to 5.7. Now we're in third place heading into the free dance.
Does that show you a little sort of consistency of opinion upon the part of the judges?
5.6 up to 5.8 for presentation, so they lead, but you've got the two that were in the lead, the top two heading into this free dance still to come. And here are the world champions, Angelika Krylova and Oleg Ovsyannikov. They've been winning everything in sight, most recently the European Championship.
The music they will skate to are modern African drums. Very risky dance for them to do. It's all drums. There's no melody. And that makes it unusual in the world of ice dancing. It's rhythm the whole way. One thing they have is extraordinary speed, very good edging. Very good technique. Thank you. those of our viewers who are dance aficionados, I relate this dance to the Duchesnes, choreographed by Christopher Dean. A totally different kind of dance. Look at that lift. One criticism that's been made of this dance is that there's a lot of side-by-side skating, which we're seeing right here, rather than face-to-face, as we're now seeing. And a variety of dance positions. This lift. Talk about complications. You know, that was a dance that I've sort of resisted for a long period of time, and yet it held me. It held my attention. I thought it was very, very intriguing, and the extensiveness, the difficulty of the technique kept my attention beautifully.
Risky, as you pointed out, but it worked. At least today it did.
I think that the real problem will come with Anasina and Pacerat, whether their more melodic dance will be favored by the judges in the upset of all times if it happens.
It would be huge here in Russia, but the judges clearly given a distinction with the two different styles.
Now, look at this final lift. One of the requirements, again, note the fact that his arms can't go above his shoulders, but she certainly gets into a rather complicated position.
Don't try this at home.
No. And watch, she ends right on toe point. Very difficult.
The Russian, European, and world champions, Belova and Ovsyannikov. The first set of marks, 5.6 up to 5.9.
And I think that's very satisfying for their coaches, Natalia Linichuk and Gennady Karpinosov, who are the 1980 Olympic ice dance champions from Lake Placid. And by the way, they all trained down in Newark, Delaware.
5.8s and 5.9s for presentation. They have set the standard. Now it's up to Anasina and Pacerat. The French team with a classical influence. They're in second place with a very real chance to win and upset the Russians. They skate next. Moments away from taking the ice, the French national champions, Marina Anasina and Gwendal Pacerat. For Marina, it's an emotional homecoming. She is originally from Russia, and this is the first time that she has returned to compete in her home country. For more, let's join Leslie Visser.
Terry, many people are aware of the emigration of great male Russian skaters. They come to train in the United States. But in a modern twist, one female skater left Russia not to train in the U.S., but to become a citizen of France. 6 years ago, Marina Anasina won the Russian junior title, then lost her partner when he fell in love with another skater. At 17, Marina had to start over, so she wrote a letter to French skater Gwendal Pacerat. He was available and interested, but he was also training in his hometown of Lyon. Marina, determined to skate, packed her bags and began a new life.
It's big difference with Russia. And at the beginning, it was not so easy to change everything. I didn't speak French. I didn't know the country at all. But now I know everything.
Marina had a lot to learn, becoming acquainted with a new partner, new choreography, a different culture, and a foreign language all at once. On the ice, she and Gwendal improvised, creating a bouillabaisse of French, English, and Russian, which allowed them to somehow make their way through the first few months of training.
Actually, we handled it pretty well during practices, mixing three languages. At the very first moment, it was okay, because when you're on the ice, it's the body who speaks more than the tongue.
Marina has adapted to her adopted city. She joined a health club and recently moved herself and her mother into a chic downtown neighborhood of Lyon. While Marina is in constant movement, Gwendol is tranquil and studious. He's working on his fourth university degree, this one in business, at a school not far from where he grew up. Unlike his emotional partner, Gwendol is cool and calm, but when they perform, the chemistry is obvious.
We're so different that we are very, very additional. And we choose not to to lose one and to take just the other one. And that's what makes our couple very rich.
In a move which has become their trademark, they perform a lift in which she appears to be holding him aloft. They see this move as a way of celebrating the opposite yet equal strengths of male and female. Yet if they are to beat the reigning European champions, they must hope that the judges are ready to embrace this feminist view as well.
An emotional weekend for Marina Anissina back home in Russia. She and Gwendol Pezera trying to overtake Krylova and Ovsyannikov.
The man in the iron mask. Now, notice how much more emotional and melodic this is than the previous dance. It presents a clear-cut difference between the two styles of ice dancing. Winter in Nagano was one of the great ice dances of all time. Notice how romantic, emotional relationship is. These lifts where she lifts him. This has been an invention of their part through several years of ice dancing, now copied by many other ice dancers and pair skaters, come to think of it.
Mm-hmm.
Great speed. Notice the intricacy of the footwork. The steps, very complicated. Thank you.
dance lift, upside down position. Very complicated. Very beautiful. I think you make your choice, you take your pick.
But you wouldn't want to be a judge right now because that's an awfully hard decision.
Well, you know something? Anasina and Pazurat, I have been absolutely great fans of theirs. I thought their performance at the Olympic Games last year was one of the brilliant ice dances of all time. In tonight's performance, I think I'd probably have to give it to our friends Krylova and Ovsyannikov because of the speed and the intricacy of the and the drama of that program.
I have to wait to find out what the judges think. We'll come back and see if they can overtake Krylova and Ovsyannikov.
I tell you, I gotta like them both.
We are back in St. Petersburg, Russia, the Hermitage, which houses over 3 million works of art. They say you can spend 70 years trying to view each one. And a reminder, coming up next year on ABC Sports, NASCAR hits the jackpot. They head out to the Las Vegas 400. Jeff Gordon trying to stay on that role. Mike Skinner, though, the points leader after two top 10 finishes so far. Dale Earnhardt will be there, Rusty Wallace, the rest of the gang. That's coming up next here on ABC Sports. So the ice dancing competition comes down to this. Marina Anasina, Gwendal Pazura, they wait, they watch for the scores.
You've got to remember that for them to beat out Krylova and Ovsyannikov will be a tremendous upset. And if so, part of it would be to these inventive moves that they do right here. Watch where she lifts him and he stretches out. Isn't that interesting? But there's one thing that if they upset Krylova and Ovsyannikov, it will be one of the major upsets in the skating world. A mind-boggling change. I don't think tonight's performance had quite the excitement and flair that it would take to have that happen.
First set of marks, Dix, 5.5 to 5.7 for technical merit. In the same ballpark, but a few higher marks for Krylova and Ovsyannikov. And for presentation, 5.8s, 5.9s, not enough. And they finish second. Anasina and Pazura once again right behind the Russians.
Well, I've got to tell you, it was beautiful skating, no matter how you slice it.
So the world champions prevail again here on their home ice. Anasina and Pazura have to be frustrated. It keeps happening to them. But they'll try again in less than 3 weeks in Helsinki. And Lomacheva and Averbuch capture third, the Russians two of the top three spots. So the victors here at the Grand Prix final, Krylova and Ovsyannikov. Shen and Zhao of China, the upset winners in the pairs competition. They're full of confidence. Their role continued. 18-year-old world champion Alexei Yagudin won the men's. And Tatiana Malinina of Uzbekistan, the ladies. We will see you next March 25th in prime time at the World Figure Skating Championships. Michael Weiss and the men take the ice then. And on Saturday the 27th, Michelle Kwan eyes her third ladies crown here in the home of the World Figure Skating Championships. For our entire ABC crew, so long from St. Petersburg, let's go back to New York and join John Saunders.